Hey guys, and welcome back to a brand new video. The past couple of days, we have taken a look at the map and we have taken a look at Branch. And there is only one more thing that we have to take a look at. The challenges. In this video, we're gonna take a look at the weekly challenge. And oh boy, I have heard from so many people that this is very difficult. Luckily, I am obviously the best Tower Hero player ever and have never lost a match in my entire life. At least I wish I was. No, this is probably gonna be really, really difficult for me, and I have no idea if I can beat it. But let's try winning it anyway. Here we go. Okay, so apparently it's only hard mode. I had no idea about that. Because I really want to win and try to win, I changed my team up a little bit. So right now I got Chef, Hoddock Frank, Branchy, Spectre and Lemonade Cat. And hopefully I can win with that. Like, I really want to try this time to actually win. So far, Chef has been able to kill everything, which is super nice. I am, however, gonna place a second one just to be safe, because on the early waves, I really don't want to miss out on HP. And in the meantime, I'm just gonna level up Lemonade Cat to just get as much mana as possible, and hopefully we can do it that way. So, we are on wave 8, and so far the first chef on level 2 has still been able to kill everything, and the second chef hasn't done anything yet. So that's good to know in case we do fail. Okay, so now the second chef. So at wave 8, I suggest having a second chef. Okay, we now get something more difficult, so let's actually upgrade this one also to wave 2, and still focus on farming. Can we kill this? No, okay, let's also get one over here then. Okay, I was a little bit too late. So let's have a temporary chef here and remove him. So I think all these chefs should be enough to kill the fire slimes. I think, and I hope so. Okay, things are getting a little bit scary, especially with the fire slimes. So I'm just gonna put as much chefs at the end at level 2 as possible, just to reduce the damage a lot. I will still take some damage, but at least I can kill some. I really think I gotta place a Hoddock Frank, just for the area of effect damage, to damage as much enemies as possible. I'm getting kinda stressed right now on wave 13. But yeah, we should still just focus and just keep our cool, I guess. So far, I feel like the Hoddock Franks are really, really helping me. I also want to place a Branchy right here, probably, just to get some spikes up. And I just think I really gotta invest in a Spectre as soon as possible, just to boost the range of Hoddock Frank, because it's getting kinda scary. It is getting really scary, to be honest. I think we actually might die here. Yeah, we're dying here. Welp, rip. Okay, so the first attempt went horrible. Absolute horrible. Let's try that again with a different strategy. Because this... oh boy, that's embarrassing. Okay, so here we are. Second attempt. This time, the thing what I want to change is I probably want to place Branch faster. And I want to place Hoddock Frank faster and probably focus a little bit less on farming and more on defending on the first couple of waves. I do know, however, that I can safely put one chef here for 8 waves, so that's amazing to know. So I changed my strategy a little bit. Instead of 2 chefs, I now placed 1 level 2 chef and 1 level 2 Branch. I hope that Branch can weaken the stronger slimes at the beginning and Chef can just focus on finishing hits instead of dealing a lot of damage. So far it seems to be working, but I feel like I need to upgrade Branch a little bit more so he attacks faster. I'm actually taking quite a bit of damage again. This is very scary. I hope I will survive this wave, but I'm actually not sure, because I'm actually taking a lot of damage here. This is very scary. I'm gonna place another chef here just to kill the slime, and let's see if we can actually win this wave, because this is very scary. Oh, that's so much damage, dude. Come on. Yeah, okay, we're dead again. We are dead again. Wave 11. It went worse. It literally went worse. How? I really gotta change things up, I guess. Okay, so I actually changed out Branch for Dumpster Child. And I hope by placing down a Dumpster Child, it gives me enough damage to get to the first couple of waves. And that way I can just focus more on farming. Because setting up right now is the biggest problem for me. Okay, we are at wave 9 now, and I get a little bit scared of the fire slimes. So I'm probably gonna put another dumpster here. I'm gonna upgrade my chef to level 2. And I'm also gonna place a chef here at level 2. And I hope that will be enough to kill the fire slimes. I think it will be. And I don't think I needed the chef. But I just wanna make sure. Because, like, above wave 10, it's scary, dude. Okay, so the first Inferno slime spawned. And those are the ones I'm really scared about. I think I can kill it now. I can, yes. Okay, so my setup right now is a level 3 dumpster. All the farms level 4. We got a level 3 chef. Then level 2 dumpster, level 2 specter, level 3 hotdog Frank. And all the way in the back, the failsafe chef, which hasn't been used yet. So I'm really happy about that. I'm probably gonna upgrade this section right here now. And then I'm gonna upgrade a path along here with a lot of chefs probably. Okay, so this corner is all the way maxed now. So I actually feel really comfortable about that. I'm probably gonna move this chef to the damage zone. But I wanna be sure that everybody can handle it before I move him. So I might wait a little with that. Ha! So at wave 25, a king slime spawns? Ha, that's very interesting. I didn't know about that. Ooh, that's very special. I wonder if all the other slimes are gonna spawn, like the thunder slime from the rooftop. I'm really curious about that. And what will the final boss be? Will it just be a bunch of king slimes? Very interesting. It's actually quite funny how many melee characters we're using. We have like a lot of chefs here, then Hotdog Frank. And then I guess you can consider Dumpster Child to be melee too. Like this challenge like only needs melee. It's super funny how the entire balance changes around the challenge. So far everything is still going good. These giant radioactive slimes are very scary. They got a lot of HP. And, like, they come all the way, like, to the ends of my attack. So, I'm always getting really... Look how close they are. I'm always getting really scared when they appeared. So far, it has all been good. But I just can't help but be scared when they spawn. It's, very scary. Okay, that's a lot of bigs. No! Oh, did we seriously just lost? Did we seriously just lose? I think we just lost. No, dude. Wave 32. That's 20 minutes. That's 20 minutes we're never getting back. That's actually 20 minutes we're never getting back. No, die, dude. Are you kidding me? How? It went so well. Bruh, 20 coins? Nah. Wow, okay, that sucks, dude. Jeez. Well, guess I couldn't do it. To be honest, I'm really proud of how far I got, but, you know, challenges like these aren't really for me. They are way too hard for me, and I don't really want to sit there with a guide. Like, if we're gonna do this with, like, a video guide, like, what's the point at that point? Like, it's fun to experiment, and if you like these kind of challenges, it's really cool and really fun, but I guess it's just not for me. But let me know if you guys have beaten it. But anyway, guys, thank you all so much for watching. If you like this video and want to see more, please hit that like and subscribe button. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye!